Hi everyone, I'm Ryan Alice, and I'm doing a video series on All That I've Learned by 28. Now, I'm going to talk about internal mastery. What is internal mastery? Well, internal mastery is becoming a master of yourself, your body, and your emotions. One of the most important studies within internal mastery is happiness, and how we can control our happiness, or at least affect it. To me, true happiness occurs when you're making a difference in the lives of others, and you're following your bliss, and doing what you love to do. And when you can align what you love to do with what you do every day, often you get into a flow state, as Csikszentmihalyi says, and that is when you reach true happiness. In fact, Mihaly Csikszentmihalyi says, a person can make himself happy or miserable, regardless of what is happening outside, just by changing the contents of consciousness. In other words, the contents of what you're choosing to think about. Obstacles and suffering are an important thing to study as well. Great psychologist Mihaly Csikszentmihalyi says, the ability to persevere despite obstacles and setbacks is one of the most important traits for succeeding in life. And oftentimes what I've found when I see amazing people out there in any field is that the more challenges they've faced, the more impressive they are. And this, as the saying goes, the hotter the temperature the iron is forged in, the stronger the steel. In other words, the more challenges they've been through in their life, the stronger their internal alignment with that which they want to achieve and their internal power to influence others. So if you're going through struggle, don't be afraid of struggle. Struggle is actually something that is important to the process of understanding the depths of what true happiness is. As they say, smooth seas don't make skillful sailors. So in order to feel the true heights of happiness, it's actually helpful to have been through some suffering in life. Because after you go through suffering, you can better empathize with others and see things from their perspective. In 2009, when my business partner Aaron had thyroid cancer, through that experience, I was better able to put myself in the shoes of other people who were going through difficult things. And as I experienced my mother's passing in 2012, earlier this year, as difficult as that experience was, I gained so much from it in terms of understanding of myself, understanding my motivations, and being able to relate to other people who were going through difficult times. Let's talk a little bit more about happiness. Happiness, in many cases, is a choice. And just like Mihaly Csikszentmihalyi said, if you can learn to control what's in your consciousness, oftentimes, you can choose to be happy. Now, you can't always control your happiness. There are sometimes certain chemical processes that can affect brain function or body function that affect your happiness or level of depression. However, in many cases, you can actually interpret the events that happen in your life differently. And you could perhaps look at life through an optimistic lens and recognize that anything that happens to you externally, you can choose how to interpret it. And oftentimes that choosing is a critical component of your level of happiness. So one of the ways that I get to sort of that Zen state or that meditative state is to take 10 minutes and just sit silently every morning and think about what I want to achieve that day. Think about my day before and think about the important things I need to do, the people that I need to interact with, and the things that I can check off my to-do list. And just meditate silently, but actively visualize how I want my day to go. Some of the habits that I follow on a weekly or daily basis. I always try to be positive as often as I can. Do what I say I'm going to do. Undercommit and overdeliver, to be transparent and open with my friends, my family, with really everyone, to keep track of the tasks and the commitments that I make, to review my goals at least once a year, like I talked about during the video on goals, to plan for the future, to seek out amazing people that I can surround myself with, and to identify great mentors from whom I can learn. Others include staying in touch with the people in my network, always continuously reading, watching educational videos about science and technology, exercising, keeping my body healthy by putting good food into my system, spending time out in nature. One of my favorite things to do is here just north of San Francisco, go hiking in Marin County, do daily meditation to really zone in with myself, and to communicate often with people in my company. The more you can communicate, oftentimes the better people can understand and predict that which you want. So beyond those habits, I also try to follow certain habits as it relates to personal health. And I still have a lot to learn about personal health, but here are some of the basics I've learned about health over the past 28 years. Now, one of the most obvious is when you want to lose weight, consume fewer calories than you burn. Very obvious, but oftentimes there are many more complicated ways of, well, weight loss programs. But what I find is that this one works for me. When I want to lose weight, I have a very special diet in which I eat only for that period of time, chicken, turkey, fish, vegetables, almonds, water, and green tea. What I've been able to recognize about the combinations and the correlations between diet and cancer is that a high calorie, high salt diet, high sodium diet with little physical activity and increased obesity greatly increases the chance of cancer. From the statistics that I've seen, 75% of cancer is caused by just three factors: tobacco, bad diet, and sun exposure. Tobacco causes 30% of cancer cases and contains 4,000 harmful chemicals and toxic carcinogens. Don't smoke. That's a critical part of health and internal mastery. In terms of eating and servings and what you put into your body, I like to have about 5 servings of vegetables a day, do some soy, tofu, miso, eat lots of beans, lentils, and whole grains. From time to time, have some nuts and melons and berries, and really have some high protein like fish, lean chicken, turkey, sometimes beef, and drink lots of water. I try to drink between 8 and 12 glasses of water a day. So I've still got a lot to learn about diet, about health, about internal mastery, but these are the things I've learned so far. Thank you for watching this video.